Can making art bring ecological awareness?
Could you describe how you've come to understand your practice, your art?
Well, I think of this word art and how we think about it today, and going back to the older way of thinking about art as the root of it is the things that you're skilled at doing, you know? And thinking about art as maybe everything that each person is gifted with. And I think about my own self as an educator. Really, what I do is I facilitate learning, someone that creates the moments where people can find learning on their own.
So how much of your art practice has been shaped by the local ecology there in Santa Clara Pueblo?
I grew up a little bit different than other kids the same age as myself. One of the things that my mom did when I was a little kid is take me and my sister out of school and was like, well, you don't really learn too much useful things in school, so you're gonna stay home and work in the fields and help build houses and fix fences and whatever it is that, you know, you need to do to help out, you know, and that's gonna be your education, you know.
How much of that, of your knowledge, your education was influenced or been ultimately shaped by the local environment or the ecology of that place?
One of the things that my mom sort of got attached to as an idea was permaculture. But permaculture being a practice, a modern day practice of basically those things that indigenous people all around the world practiced as a way of, if you think about permaculture as permanent culture, allowing themselves to carry on their cultures in relationship with the places that they're at, right? And so one of the things that my mom really thought about is how our traditional practices of agriculture, of living on the land, was something that passed down through generation after generation, very much was also the same kind of ideas that you would find in something like permaculture, right? She was raising me and my sister with those ideas of that relationship with the patterns of the places that we lived at, you know, at Santa Clara Pueblo.
How do you incorporate some of those ideas of permaculture into your practice as an educator?
One of the things that you can see at, say, for example, at a formal art school is that when you start the class, you get your course supply list, right? And you need to go to the art supply store and buy this kind of pencil or that kind of charcoal or this kind of paint, right? The relationship with where do these things come from or how are they made is sort of broken at that moment when you go to the store to buy those things to create your art, right? And so one of the things that's really important to me in traditional arts is reestablishing that relationship with where the materials you need to make what you need to make come from, right? So one of the things that I have students do for, say, for example, for the weaving class, right? On the first week of class, we go out to go start doing textiles, right? But there's no tools, no supply list. What we do is we go out into the hills right there on campus and start looking for tools. Find sharp rocks and rocks with a flat edge. We go and cut yucca. We prep it. We put it into a container with water. We allow it to ferment for about a week. Then we process those fibers and turn it into cordage. And to me, it's something very basic, making cordage out of plant fibers, right? It's something that goes way back into the depths of the human experience, right? And so yet, that's not something that's passed down to us generation to generation anymore, right? And so you can see that also in the architecture class, in terms of actually making the bricks out of mud and then turning those bricks into walls, you know, and that all of these things come from the environment that we live in. And to me, one of the most rewarding moments as a facilitator of learning is seeing that moment when the students have figured out, hey, I don't need to go and buy this stuff. I can go and make this all on my own, you know? Mm. And I said, at that moment, learning is happening, you know? And not only that, that in a small little way, I have created the space for them to regain back some of their inheritance as human beings.
What's the significance of somebody from who's not from this area learning how to make Adobe homes?
For students that are in my classroom, who are come from really different places, I'm not going to be the one to tell them how to have a relationship with their place. And maybe through seeing how people thrived and continue to thrive in this particular place, it can give them, spark them, in them the desire to learn about how to establish relationship in their places.
Why is it important to consider your local ecology, whether it be in a creative practice or a formal institutional setting?
That relationship and the responsibility that is part of that relationship was what allowed us to thrive for so many generations, to exist even today, right? So reestablishing a relationship entails that there is responsibility tied with that.